is it really? These kids. Some of the kids are running, they don't even know why.
air show routine is a high energy and action-packed display of unlimited aerobatics. The X-540 model plane aircraft.
Wow, this maneuver is called a spiraling power, pointing that airplane straight up in the sky. Spiraling on up and pushing over the edge. Coming back to air show center to focus on this airplane high. Rolling inverted, rolling right side up.
The Sioux Falls Area Convention and Visitors Bureau, Altig Engineers, Woods, Fuller, Schultz, and Smith, thank you, corporate sponsors.
And Jeff, we have a bonanza at Airshow Center. Smoke is on. A bonanza can do this, Jeff?
I love Jim Bites Aerosports because he's taken a casual, everyday airplane that you can see on the ramp at any airport in the United States, the Bonanza, but he's doing something with it that nobody else does. The airplane that Jim is flying today is a very special aircraft. It's one of the few built by Beechcraft that have been certified by the FAA for aerobatics. This is not your daddy's Bonanza, and please Don't try this at home.
Especially this maneuver, pulling that airplane up straight into the sky right before it stops falling. Kicks hard left rudder, a hammerhead, a perfect button hook in the sky. Good turnaround maneuver.
Jim Pites is a South Dakota native, and he's totally immersed in aviation. Any pilot in general aviation in this state knows this gentleman. He's an owner of an FBO that includes charter air flight and flight instruction, but his favorite thing to do is perform this high G, high angle Bonanza air show. Look at the way he maneuvers this airplane. You're not supposed to be able to do that in a Bonanza. I don't think Ben and little Joe and Hoss ever thought of flying a Bonanza this way.
Not as good as Jim. That last maneuver was a barrel roll followed by a wing over. Kids, here's an 8-point roll. Help me count the points on the roll. There's one and two, three, four. He's inverted. There's five, six, seven, and eight. An 8-point roll in Jim's beautiful Bonanza.
Now on the right side, on the north end of runway 03, balancing the two parts of his energy equation, altitude and airspeed, he trades one to get the other, roaring back down right on top of the concrete, Jim Pites in his Bonanza, full of the nose, straight up, rolling into that 90 degree point, 180, 270, 360, 4-point hesitation roll of Jim Pites.
The next maneuver he's setting up for is a Cuban 8. This is the figure 8 laying on its side. He starts a loop on the 45 degree downline, rolls to the right side. There is one half of a figure 8 laying on its side there, folks. Let's watch him closely off to air show right. Pulling back on the stick, pulling that stick in his lap. The airspeed's dropping down to 30, 40, 50. Over the top of that loop. Picking up a 45 degree downline, rolling the aircraft right side up. Jim has just completed a Cuban 8, the figure 8 laying on its side.
Jim's probably best known for his high G gyroscopic show that he does in the Extra 300, but he's been amazed at the response he gets for this aerobatic Bonanza. He says, and I quote, "I guess it's just a surprise factor. People don't expect to see a four-place family airplane on its back doing a snap roll or going vertical. It just doesn't look right."
No, it doesn't look right, but this man knows how to fly. Jim can fly quite a few different airplanes. He's been around the South Dakota area for many, many years. And we welcome him to Sioux Falls. This is a double roll that he's completing from air show left to air show right.
Had a chance to visit with Jim Pites this weekend, and Jim feels just like I do. He believes that aviation is one of the greatest freedoms that we enjoy and totally out of control. That's the pinnacle of any pilot's aviation career. Jim Pites is currently serving his second term on the International Council of Air Shows Board of Directors. He's one of the leaders of the air show community.
And coming in from the air show right, low and fast, smoke is on a photo pass. A beautiful shot of the top side of the Bonanza. Jim Pites.
As Jim repositions over Elmwood Golf Course, Lisa, I can feel the electricity. The rock stars are here. Get ready for the Blue Angels, Sioux Falls.
I can feel the heat at 2 p.m. sharp. We are turning over the airfield, the airspace, the microphone, and everything associated with it.
Oh, dear Lord. F-130 is capable of carrying a payload of 40,000 pounds at a top speed of 375 miles per hour at altitudes as high as 35,000 feet. Major Drew Hess from Rockford, Illinois, Major Brendan Burns from Auburn, Alabama, and Captain Edward George from Hollywood, Florida. The enlisted air crew for today's performance are Flight Engineer Donnie Farr from Casper, 1,000 pounds of fuel, 32,000 pounds of equipment, and a specialized maintenance and support team of 47 personnel.
I've been everywhere, man, across the desert, spare man, I breathe the mountain air, man.
Currently operate aerial refueling versions of the C-130. The KC-130 is capable of providing tactical in-flight refueling of jet, helicopter, and tiltrotor aircraft. Additionally, Marine KC-130s have been used extensively in support of Marine expeditionary units throughout the world. They have most recently been employed in operations in North Africa. George will establish Bad Albert on a very steep approach angle to simulate landing in mountainous terrain or a hostile environment, demonstrating their short field landing capability. They will touch down, immediately reposition the propellers to full reverse, stopping the aircraft in just 1,500 feet. You will notice that not only can the aircraft stop quickly, but it can actually taxi backwards. The Blue Angels have had the unique privilege of demonstrating the American public the precision techniques of naval aviation, hoping to...
From right to left, the B-25 is official, flown by Alan Miller and Mark Harris. The B-25 is featured in the 1961 novel,
Built by C-130 has launched into the tower. Let me come back around to the passengers.
The Hercules family has the longest continuous production run of any military aircraft in history. During more than 50 years of service, the family has participated in complex military, civilians, and humanitarian aid operations. Over 2,200 of these have been made. There is a crew of five aboard this aircraft, two pilots, a navigator, a flight engineer, and a load master. It is a big airplane. It can hold up to 92 passengers, or 64 airborne troops, or 74 litter patients with two medical personnel, or six pilots, or basically a payload of 45,000.
This is the aerobatics and
finals. You got it.
was executed. This aircraft was delivered to the Army Air Corps in March of 1945. It was shipped to England and prepared for battle.
Look at how thin that fuselage and wing is. That's a tough target to hit. If you're in an air-to-air engagement, that's the airplane you want to stay. Slumpy's
doing a great job as he holds that inverted line,
rocking those wings back and forth through the air show playground, the air show box. Great job of flying that B-51 Mustang.
If you would like to ride in this Mustang, the rides are
here. It comes. Passing in review. The B-51 has enjoyed a resurgence.
The largest flying museum in the world with over 140 aircraft, mostly World War II vintage, located at over 100 wings and squadrons across all of America. Lumpy, once an airshow pilot, always an airshow pilot. Another photo pass.
Performances. We get to show you all of the different types of formations that can be flown when you got four talented pilots with the right stuff filling those cockpits. Look at the Vanguards in their beautiful opening maneuver, the fingertip loop. Now, what is it like to be in tight formation like that? Well, while they're in formation, the wingmen never, ever take their eyes off of that lead airplane. The first rule of formation flying is thou shalt not lose sight of the airplanes you are flying formation with. So the wingmen don't care if the leader is right side up, upside down, or inside out. He becomes the whole attitude, reference, and world for the wingman. Watch this. Very subtle, graceful maneuver. The number four pilot is actually changing positions during the roll itself. The beautiful fingertip to diamond roll. Now reconfigured in that classic signature Vanguard diamond. The lead pilot, in contrast to those wingmen, he never looks at the other guys. He's looking at you, Sioux Falls. That's because it's the job of the lead pilot to fly for all four airplanes at once. And that means he's got to correct and center and choreograph for the winds that are aloft. Back in that beautiful diamond formation, less than 3 feet of wingtip clearance. Look at that tight diamond as they float across the top of a zero-G loop in the zero-gravity environment, hanging from their belt straps just like an astronaut. The Vanguards are looking really good today. This is what these guys love to do. You can find us just about any nice evening of the week, hanging out down at the T Airport. You see those airplanes with smoke coming out of them? Those are the Vanguards. The Vanguards want to send out a happy birthday to Derek Myers today. Derek, happy 10th birthday. And also we want to welcome Todd Eslick's parents, Rich and Colleen. Todd flies on the right wing as number three. As they come back in to the center of the air show playground, four Vanguards. Their smoke is off for a reason. They pull into the loop, but they're going to twist that loop 90 degrees to the horizon. That's called a quarter clover leaf turn. Folks, do not blink. Here is the moment you came to see. Using their airplanes like paintbrushes against the canvas of the Sioux Falls sky, smoke in just the right places, and element heartbreak to draw a big, beautiful heart for Sioux Falls. The Vanguards love ya. Now, how are they gonna get this formation back together? You can see they're all split up. Well, if you have to think about it, it's already the original Red Baron roll around his leader. He's gonna park it back into formation, followed by Todd Eslick. And the number four pilot, Todd Schoppenbuehl, the spectacular triple rolling rejoin. They'll glue that formation right back together into a tight diamond for their next series of maneuvers. These airplanes have been burning ethanol since 1993, and as agricultural yields increase through modern farming practices and technology, hundreds of billions of gallons of fossil fuels can be displaced using the same amount of land that is being farmed today. our efforts here in America could be duplicated to relieve the energy needs of the entire planet, putting fossil fuels where they belong, in the pages of history. The Vanguard Squadron proud to carry the name Poet on the side of our airplanes as we spread the message of ethanol across the Airshow community and airshows across the United States. Now lined up in echelon formation, the beautiful Cascade Roll. Rolling away from each other to take a little spacing. They fall into trail. And now we're gonna have a little fun with the Vanguards, because now we're gonna play some follow the leader through a series of tail chase maneuvers. This is so much fun to fly. All you have to do is the wingman, as the trailer, is line up the smoke on top of your head and follow the guy in front of you smoke. Now we're gonna daisy chain through a barnstormer's loop done in quadruplicate. Here comes another highlight maneuver of the sequence, folks. Watch the Vanguards as they go straight up the long, delirious, burning blue in trail. Holy cow, it's the spectacular staggerhead turn. Four hammerheads done in trail brings the team straight back down from left to right. As they follow each other through a beautiful lazy barrel roll, actually a precision roll. The nose comes up, the pilot finds the 90 degree point on the left side of his shoulder, and in a constant rate of roll, rolls around that point on the right side with enough energy to reposition with a 1/2 Cuban 8 turn on the back side of the 45 degree down line. The pilots roll back to upright for another tail chase loop. Now's a great chance to introduce our pilots. The lead pilot, Gary Coons, flying on the left wing for the Vanguards. The guy who taught me to fly, Steve Thompson. On the right wing is number three, our newest aviator, Todd Eslick. Flying the difficult slot position as number four, Todd Schappenbuehl. Two Todds. T2, we call the second element, the second part of the loop. Something going on here. What's this going to be? It looks like they're skywriting. There it is. It's a big E for ethanol. That's a pretty good E for a windy day. The winds are aloft, so I always hesitate to announce that. But the Vanguards want to remind you once again to join the E team by going to growthenergy.org. You can always visit the Vanguards online. The Vanguard photo pass in review. Look at that tight formation. Nice job, guys. The formation flying does not end until the propellers wind down, and if we have a chance, that's when we'll ask you to give them a great big Sioux Falls round of applause. The Vanguards face down at the T Airport.
Jeff?
Steve's climbed up to get some altitude. He'll use that altitude to build up a big head of hyposonic steam as he comes in on the left side of the airshow rebound. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Phelan in the souped up hot rod. We call the pit special. Look at that head banging roll rate as he rolls the airplane upside down and inverted, moving from the left to the right across runway 03 on the right side of the airshow box. Steve pulls back on the stick and hangs the airplane on the vertical line, pulling back right before he runs out of airspeed. Prop blast alone, traveling over the horizontal stabilizer, allowing him to continue to maneuver the airplane at extremely low speeds. The Pitt Special is always a great airplane to have on the bill. 4 points on the head.
Cherokee 140, and as all pilots are aware, the quest for more aviation is nonstop. His first airplane was a Mirage Ultralight. Since then, he has owned a Sonarai, an RB4, a Christian Eagle, a Pips S2B, and now he flies the Pips S1S in this air show routine.
He uses this line perfectly. Using the maneuvers reference, pulling it down.
centered and corrected for the ocean of Earth, moving across Bill Cross Field, and there behaves just like
through the horizon. Commander McWhirter rolls a formation, 180 degrees, pulling through the inverted. The four Diamond pilots will complete this maneuver and accelerate descent, picking up the necessary airspeed for their next maneuver. Four Diamond pilots will experience four times of the force of gravity required to complete this looping maneuver. you an opportunity to take a close look at that very minimum. 18-inch wingtip to canopy separation that exists between these four aircraft. From the right, the Blue Angel, Diamond. Two solo pilots approaching center point. Major Miller and Lieutenant Weiser will roll their aircraft into a 90 angle of bank. Push forward the stick as they perform the opposing knife edge pass. Who understand that difficult transition from the cruise to the landing configuration will appreciate this next maneuver demonstrated by our two solo pilots. go. Biplane, line up, rest, loop. To the left. Commander McWhirter calls for another formation change. Prior to detaching Blue Angel number 5. Separate direction. Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Angel vertical. Once again, the beautiful weather of the Imperial Valley provide us with optimum conditions. Apply each of the demonstration pilots on the 120 training flights necessary prior to our first public demonstration. Our show season opened on the 14th of March and runs continuously each weekend through mid-November. The Blue Angels will be performing 66 flight demonstrations this season while visiting 34 cities throughout the continental United States and Canada.